Kevin, we know that Colin Powell is a product of the South Bronx and of the New York City public school system, and also the son of immigrants from Jamaica. And he doesn't shy away from sharing that part of who he was and where he's come from. But what did that represent or mean to so many Americans with similar origin stories?
Look, it was foundational to who Colin Powell was. And like a lot of Black men who grew up, you know, in Black communities, born in Harlem, and Harlem had a certainly a great historic presence as in some ways the capital of Black America. You know, he was someone who represented himself and represented Black America. And as you said, the son of Jamaican immigrants made him very proud. He carried that, he wore that. He liked to tell stories about that. And he, you know, he carried that all the way into his career into the military.
You were a reporter, you know, sort of bearing witness to this rise. And I'm curious for you, as a Black man, also a part of this landscape and ecosystem of navigating a complicated and challenging history, what did he represent for people? And how was that a part of his legacy?
Well, you know, we in our community first are really important, and success is important. And every time someone has success at a high level, if you become chairman of the Joint Chiefs, that is a huge accomplishment. And being the first Black man to be chairman of the Joint Chiefs and followed by the first Black Secretary of State, these are huge accomplishments that people are proud of. And he never put distance from himself and Black communities, and very accessible whenever you would see him, and he would see kids, take time to stop and talk to them, really comfortable in his skin, which I think everyone appreciates. You know, his rise was a really striking rise because the more that people saw him, they began to fasten onto him their own expectations. Could he become the first Black president? And that became, I think, a long kind of dance and courtship that people began to see. Well, this could be the prototype of someone who could be embraced across not only party lines, but be embraced across gender, racial lines, and every kind of line. And that became kind of something that just sat there for many, many, many years in his life. And I think he, you know, wrestled with that.
You bring up such a good point about so many people seeing Colin Powell as a potential prototype for success or for achievement, and that he represented that for a lot of people. And one of the other really, you know, interesting and charming things about him is that he proudly touts that he was a mediocre student, a subpar C-making high school student. And I'm curious about, you know, what that tells us about him and about people's capacity to kind of own their past and evolve at the same time.
Well, look, it helped me say that, you know, I was a mediocre student too. Colin Powell can say that. I felt good about saying it. I think it says a lot about it's not where you start, but where you finish. And Colin Powell was really proud of his achievements, but he also didn't take himself too seriously. You know, he was very comfortable in his skin. You know, he let people see him the way he was. He didn't, you know, he certainly had bars and stripes and uniforms, but he also was regular in a way that not many people in Washington were, formal but regular. And I think it was really good to see someone of his stature to be someone you could aspire to.